My name is Harriet Long. I am the Advocacy Officer. I'm based in the Rainbow Project and I work for gay and lesbian men and women, and I work for transgender men and women. Advocacy means to speak on someone's behalf. So a lot of my work would be speaking on the behalf of individuals that come to me with problems. They've maybe been experiencing discrimination, or they've had an act of violence committed towards them. They've maybe had some harassment. They've maybe been made homeless because of their sexual orientation or because they're transgender. But I also speak on behalf of groups, and I suppose the wider community that would identify as gay or transgender, and for shorthand we say LGBT. And I would maybe go out and meet with a group and hear about some of their issues. For transgender people, the issue of obtaining the appropriate identity documents, and I would maybe liaise a little bit with the organisation that's responsible for making that happen. I do a lot of training and a lot of awareness raising, highlighting the issues for people who are gay or transgender. There's a big issue for gay and transgender people in Northern Ireland, that they experience discrimination and negative attitudes. We call that homophobia if it's someone who's gay, or transphobia if it's someone who's transgender. And they experience negative attitudes. It could be something that's said to them verbally. It could be being badly treated. It could be things thrown at them, damage to their property or their car, or their belongings. It could begin in the school or a youth group. It could be in the local area at the bus stop. Could be at their home, it could be from within the family. We've supported young men who've been physically assaulted or made homeless because they've come out as gay to their family. And that would involve reporting to the police service. It would involve maybe liaising with the housing executive. It would maybe mean contacting homeless hostels to see where these people can stay. And unfortunately, in Northern Ireland, there's a lack of confidence for transgender people and gay people about coming forward and accessing public services, which is what the police is or the housing executive is, because they may be nervous that they will have a homophobic experience and people won't know what to do or say with them, or they maybe will say something negative or not pay any attention to them or take it seriously. Or they may have heard that somebody has actually had a bad experience and that's why they're afraid of that. So they could perceive barriers even if they're not there. And one of the things that we're really pleased about is that the police service over a number of years have been working to improve their reputation with the gay and transgender community, to improve their relationships and to build confidence and to build trust. The policing board are launching their thematic review of how policing is done for the gay and transgender communities. And we're really pleased to see it. We're really pleased with the report. It's very, very thorough. It spent a lot of time talking to different individuals and different groups, people that have been served by the police service, victims of crime, but also people who have served within the police service. When it was the RUC a long time ago, but also people who are currently in the PSNI and are maybe out as gay police officers, or maybe not out and have maybe wouldn't feel comfortable coming out or are nervous of being in the police. So the report has been very, very thorough. It's asked a lot of people for their views and their perspectives and their experiences, and we're really pleased with some of the recommendations that they've made to just improve the way that policing is done and the way that the gay and transgender community is thought about within the police service. And we've met some brilliant, brilliant people in the police service who are really committed to building that trust, building that confidence and building those relationships. They will actively come out to events, they will make themselves known, they will introduce themselves to groups as well as victims of crime and incidents. We've had police officers come down and meet young people who are terrified to go to a police station. They're terrified of reporting because they're not out. They don't want to tell their family that they're out. And we've also met police officers that don't really understand why there may be issues, there may be sensitivities, and they've been very interested in understanding what some of the barriers are for gay and transgender people. about reporting crime.